Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise.
You're watching Spotlight, and today I'm joined by Julie Jancis and Bonnie Wheaton of the DuPage Symphony Orchestra. So welcome.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, our pleasure. Julie, I'm going to start right out with you. I know that primarily the DSO performs here in Naperville, right, at the North Central College, Wentz Hall. And so tell us a little bit about the DuPage Symphony Orchestra and your background.
Sure. Well, we've been in the community for 65 years. A lot of our patrons refer to us as Naperville's Symphony Orchestra. And we perform, as you said, primarily at Wentz Hall. We perform over 17 events each year just in Naperville alone. We do 5 concerts that are subscription concerts. We do 5 family concerts and a number of outreach programs.
Okay. And I know, I mean, having been at Wentz Hall, that is a wonderful facility for music, right?
It is acoustically amazing.
Yes, that's what we hear. Some of the best in the country. So, yeah, so nice to have that right here in our hometown.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. Now, Bonnie, this is hard for me to even believe, but you have been with the DSO for 48 years. I just can't even believe that. You don't look nearly old enough for that. But talk about your experience with the DSO.
Yeah, even though I've been playing with the DSO for 48 years, I'm still only third in seniority.
Ah, I can't believe that.
We have a lot of people who are really devoted musicians who have other jobs in their lives. We have physicians, we have teachers, we have, nuclear scientists. But the one thing that we have in common is our love of music. It's a wonderful experience to play with other people who love music and want to bring that to the community. It's great to be a part of something that is bigger than each of us individually. I like to say that under the wonderful baton of our music director, Barbara Schubert, she makes the whole greater than the sum of its parts. So altogether, we sound better than I think each of us sounds individually. It's a wonderful experience.
Oh, isn't that nice? And I have seen you and the performance are obviously wonderful, but what I love that you talk about is really what it's like to be as a performer and part of what that's giving back to you personally.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah,
it's wonderful.
Yeah. A favorite? What might be one of your favorite concerts?
The last concert that we played a couple of weeks ago, I think we played better than ever before. We played the Mendelssohn Scottish Symphony, and it was such a wonderful experience to have everybody in sync at the same time. And from the reaction of the audience, I think they felt what we were feeling too.
Yeah, lovely. Absolutely wonderful. Now, Julie, you do a lot of both youth education, right, and community outreach programs with the DSO. So give us a little bit more information on that.
Sure. We have a wealth of programs for children of all ages in Naperville. We have, and DuPage County. We have open dress rehearsals before each of our subscription concerts. All the information's on our website, but children can come and see our maestra conduct the orchestra and hear how she conducts and what she's saying and how she's changing things even the night before the concert. So they get to see that live and in action. And then we have this great sponsor, Quinlan and Fabish, that works with almost all the schools here in Naperville and provides instruments to children. And they offer a petting zoo, that they call it, after the concert, where children can actually go and try new instruments. And we have so many young children that go and try an instrument and then end up wanting to play.
Isn't that wonderful? Because I think so many things in life, right, you got to try it, you know,
yes.
And so until you do, you don't know whether you're going to like it.
Right.
So that gives that real hands-on. And what are some of the reactions from the kids when they're sitting there? I mean, I can imagine, you know, as you're Bonnie, could you just kind of speed up the tempo there a little bit? You know, how do they react to some of that instruction? And
well, I think it's a great opportunity for them to see that the critiquing isn't harsh. It is needed for everybody to come together as an orchestra, to work as a team, and to present this beautiful music to the audience.
Yeah.
Plus, they get brownies afterwards.
Oh, well, that's always a high motivator, right?
Right.
A little bit of food, a little bit of music. I like that, too. A little bit of food, a little bit of music. How do you feel about those open rehearsals?
I enjoy it. The orchestra members go out in the vestibule of Wentz and interact with the people who are there as well. The kids will come up and ask somebody, and sometimes the musicians take their instruments out. It's a little hard for me to take my cello out.
Yeah, but kind of a big thing to be moving out there.
But it's a real community effort between the orchestra and the audience members.
That's nice to get that engagement, right?
Right.
Sure. Now, Bonnie, talk, because I think you also have some other community programs that you do, right?
Yes, we also have students from the area high schools who are invited to come and play with us for just one concert to get an idea of what it's like to be playing with adults rather than just with other high school students. So if you come to the concert and you see some kids who look, or some people who look very young to be playing in the orchestra, they're probably our high school students.
What an amazing opportunity to be given, though, right? Because that's not something that too many kids get a chance to do.
Right.
And certainly not with the caliber of orchestra as the DSO is. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, I know on your website you have this thing called Making Music Memories.
Yes.
Explain that motto.
That is a campaign for our 65th anniversary year this year, and we are collecting music memories, your first music memory, from our patrons, from the community, and we're getting some wonderful stories back. We have one musician who was telling us that her daughter saw a holiday concert when she was 5 years ago. And she loved the violin so much that she took her mom's face in her hands 3 times the next week and said, "Mom, I want to play the violin." And it was right before Christmas, so her mom ran out, got her a violin, and it was just a toy violin. But she ended up loving it so much that when she was 7, they had her start playing. She's still playing today, and she says her dream is to play with the DSO when she gets older.
Oh! Wow, doesn't that make you feel so good about the work that you're doing?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, that's great. So now you're doing that all year long. Is that something that people can keep giving you memories, or you're already done with all of that?
No, we would love to hear your music memories and share them with us on our website.
Okay, that's wonderful. Well, we'll encourage viewers to do that.
Perfect, thank you.
Yes. Bonnie, as we get ready to wrap up, what else would you like to let people know about the concerts that you have coming up in the new year? Tell us a little bit.
Our first concert after the new year is on February 9th at 7:30 at Wentz Hall. It will be mostly Beethoven, and we're practicing already. We've started rehearsing a wonderful Beethoven violin concerto. It's something that audience members will probably recognize from the very first notes that we play. But it's, you can't get any better than Beethoven.
You can't. I love, that's my favorite, I have to say. Yeah.
Right. So we welcome everyone to come and enjoy something that is sort of the orchestra's gift to Naperville.
Yeah, I love that. That's a great way to put it. It is a gift. I mean, I feel very much that it's the gift of music, and you're right there in downtown Naperville, so you can enjoy all of that as well.
Right.
Thank you so much for coming by. We wish you all the best in the rest of your 65th season, and hoping that we get many more Making Music Memories that will come into your website.
Thank you so much for having us.
You're welcome. If you are interested in learning more about the DuPage Symphony Orchestra or any of their upcoming concerts, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break, but stay with us. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.